motivated.
Get motivated. Hip hop motivated. Flow of wisdom on the mic with Sean Anthony.
Get motivated.
All right, hour two, Flow of Wisdom. We are rolling. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I am your host, Sean Anthony. The website, flowofwisdom.com. Get connected with me there. And thank you for listening. Broadcasting live every Sunday, 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 12 noon Pacific, on the Genesis Communications Network. So let's look at a couple of things. You know, we're talking about this mysterious UFO program that the Pentagon has confirmed in an article published yesterday in the New York Times. And you have these wealthy billionaires investing their own money and probably others' money to develop the technology to go into outer space. What does that all lead to? What does all of that mean? You know, what does that all entail? What else can derive from this type of progressive movement, you know, in our society? We're definitely in an era where, of course, with artificial intelligence being incorporated in just about everything now, we look at different programs like the Large Hadron Collider, the facility in CERN, Switzerland, colliding particles. It's a particle accelerator. These particles collide, and you know, you look at that, then you look at the quantum computing, the D-Wave quantum computer, very, very powerful computer, D-Wave systems. A quantum computer taps directly into the fundamental fabric of reality, the strange and counterintuitive world of quantum mechanics, to speed computation. Rather than store information, this is the quantum computer, guys. Rather than store information as zeros or ones, as conventional computers do, a quantum computer uses what they call qubits. Qubits, which can be a one or a zero or both at the same time. This quantum, what they call superposition, along with the quantum effects of entanglement and quantum tunneling, it enables quantum computers to consider and manipulate all combinations of bits simultaneously, making quantum computation powerful and fast. You know how you could take a math problem and you can arrange it many different ways to get the equation, right? Traditional computers, you have to do it one way at a time. With a quantum computer, you can explore all problems simultaneously. I'm really trying to get, you know, explain it in a simplistic way so that we can have some understanding. So when I talk about this stuff, it's just like, whoa, this stuff is going over my head. I want to break it down very, very simple. Most computer people that are tech savvy, or at least have some sort of understanding of tech and computers, the traditional computers, that everything is programmed with like ones and zeros. Think about the Matrix movie. That opening scene, all you see is those zeros and ones. Remember that? The movie, The Matrix. Imagine those zeros and ones being layered on top of one another now. It just changes the dynamics, okay, of computing, of computation. So they're using this D-Wave system, this quantum computer. And Gordy Rose, who was the founder of D-Wave, he has come out and said, hey, this stuff can tap into different universes and so on and so forth. You know, parallel universes. My friend Wilbur Allen, who I've had on the show numerous times, who has lots of documentation, lots of photographs that you can see on his website, which I mentioned in the last hour, ufodc.com. His belief is that these flying objects, mind you, that if you guys are just tuning in, he photographs outside of his home in Washington, D.C., just over top of the Capitol, okay? He believes that these flying objects are traveling to and fro through portals, or what he calls wormholes. And essentially, it's going to parallel universes. There's an interesting article, and it's called Parallel Universes Are Real and Will Soon Be Testable, researchers say. And the article is really is interesting because it references a book called The Hidden Reality, Parallel Universes and the Deep Laws of the Cosmos by Dr. Brian Greene. They say that they posed a question. Is there a copy of you reading this article at the precise moment in a parallel universe? So there's a lot of physicists, scientists, really researching this subject matter of parallel universes, multi-dimensions. MIT's Max Tegmark trusts that this multi-universe model of many universes is grounded in modern physics and will ultimately be testable, predictive, and disprovable. It says a rising number of cosmologists agree with Green that we are but one of many universes, and nonetheless, one of these other worlds lies close to ours, maybe only a millimeter away. So I want to ask you guys, do you believe that there are different multi-universes? Do you think there are parallel universes? And this also brings up the question, I don't know if you guys have heard the whole thing on the internet about the Mandela effect. The Mandela effect being that something that you knew to be true, something that you remember growing up as a child to be one way, now it no longer exists anymore. And they're saying that, you know, some of this has to do with the Large Hadron Collider and, you know, multi-universes, and that they're messing with you know, the whole dynamics of the parallel universes and stuff like that. Like, I'm trying to think of an example. Like Chick-fil-A. How is Chick-fil-A spelled right now? I some people say that it used to be with a K in it. It used to have a K in Chick-fil-A or something like that. But now it's no longer spelled that way. These are things that they're talking about. Also, another thing in the Mandela effect is something about a particular Bible scripture, certain scriptures. I think it was like the Lord's Prayer, a way that you knew it to be true, but now when you look into the Bible, the Lord's Prayer is read differently. It has different wording. So, back to this article, Parallel Universes Are Real. As study at the CERN, Large Hadron Collider progresses, researchers are talking gradually of a new physics on the horizon, which has potential to help scientists comprehend more of the unknown's mysteries of our universe. This is what they're using the Large Hadron Collider to tap into. and essentially looking for dark matter as well. Forgot to mention that. Dark matter, invisible dark matter, makes up most of the universe, they say. But we can only detect it from its gravitational pull. This new methodology includes increasing a better understanding of dark energy, an anonymous force that some forward thinkers believe shows that a sister universe lurks in our neighborhood. There's been all kinds of peculiar happenings over the years, and they're exploring this. Scientists at the WMAP Space Telescope just found a force 10,000 times greater than the Milky Way's gravity, which they believe provides strong proof that a parallel universe may be there. In another effort to search for parallel worlds, NASA mounted the Alpha Magnetic Spectrometer 2 at the ISS to record data that may show the presence of other universes, some of which might even be made of antimatter. So the stage is definitely set, and the big name players are all in the game. The question is to you, do you buy into it? Don't go anywhere. There's more right after this on Flow of Wisdom Radio. All right, welcome back. Flow of Wisdom Radio. Sean Anthony. Broadcasting live every Sunday, 3 p.m., 12 noon Pacific on the Genesis Communications Network. So we're talking about UFOs, the Pentagon's mysterious UFO program, now confirmed in the New York Times article. We're talking about parallel universes, the tie-ins between the CERN Large Hadron Collider and the quantum computer, the D-Wave quantum computers. I was giving you a little explanation of dark matter, because some of the research over at CERN is that they were looking for the God particle, what they call, and also dark matter, looking for it. So all kind of things are tied into this information. And it's quite fascinating, I would like to say. But, you know, back to the dark matter, I don't know if I got all the way through it with you guys. But this dark matter is dark energy, which they say makes up approximately 68% of the universe, and appears to be associated with the vacuum in space. It's distributed evenly throughout the universe, not only in space, but also in time. In other words, its effect is not diluted as the universe expands. This even distribution means that dark energy does not have any local gravitational effects, but rather a global effect on the universe as a whole, which leads to a repulsive force, which tends to accelerate the expansion of the universe. You know, let me just take a pause here. Because when you study physics and stuff is fascinating to me. I really get into it. It's really interesting to me. But when we think of dimensions, you know, we think of the realm that of what we see and what we can comprehend. You know, time, up, down, left, right, you know, sight, sound. What are the other dimensions out there? What if there are alternative dimensions? What if there are other dimensions outside of what we can see. I mean, it's just, it's really, really crazy when you start to think about it. An article, researchers at the Large Hadron Collider are confident to make contact with parallel universe in days. This stuff is as far-fetched as it seems like, but this is really a very real conversation that they're talking about. Atom Smasher. This thing, the Large Hadron Collider, by the way, it's in Switzerland, okay? And it's a particle accelerator. It collides these particles, atoms, neutrons, protons, etc. It smashes them together with a gravitational force that's 100,000 times stronger than the gravitational pull of the sun. That's how strong these particles are being smashed together. But anyway, at the CERN Center in Geneva, Switzerland, they use these energy levels, like I said, to attempt to spot or even generate tiny black holes. Okay? So, if successful, a totally new universe will be exposed. Like, is that crazy or what? This thing is creating tiny black holes. And there's been physicists, people that work there have come out and said that, look, something can come out or something can go in. It's very, very real. Parallel universes. We'll talk more about it. Don't go anywhere, guys. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. All right, 877-300-7645. Let's get you guys interactive here. Call in, be a part of the show. Let me know your thoughts. Welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio. Sean Anthony here, broadcasting live every Sunday, 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Let's talk about this real quick. China, I mentioned this briefly in a previous hour, that China is looking to build a bigger Large Hadron Collider, twice the size, seven times more powerful than the one that's in Switzerland. China's planning to build, and this is out of the Daily Galaxy, and we've talked about this before if you guys have been following the program, but it's okay. I know we have new listeners, and I appreciate it. China is planning to build an enormous particle accelerator twice the size and seven times as powerful as CERN's Large Hadron Collider. According to China Daily, the new facility will be capable of producing millions of Higgs boson particles, a great deal more than a Large Hadron Collider, which originally discovered what they call the God particle back in 2012. Now, this thing is completed. They finished it, I think, at the end of last year. So, and I got to really take my hats off to China. Because they really capitalizing off of this technology. You got Hanson Robotics over there based in Hong Kong. Hanson Robotics is the company behind Sophia, the most advanced humanoid robot. They call it Sophia. They're doing the first head transplant in China. Okay. And now this, they've got a large Hadron Collider, bigger than the one in Switzerland. The one in Switzerland, and I'm going off the top of my head, if I'm not mistaken, it's about 17 and a half miles long in diameter. It's a big circle, and it's underground. It's deep underneath the earth, and it's so large that it goes through not only Switzerland, but borders a portion of France. It goes into France as well. And they've done specials on CERN on 60 Minutes. You could see these articles. And when they first did it, I was like, hey, that's what the stuff I'm talking about on my show, you know? I'm like, finally, maybe people will start believing what I'm saying and stop calling me a conspiracy theorist, you know? But there's specials. You can go on CBS.com or whatever, 60Minutes.com, and go find those specials, those interviews, where they go inside the Large Hadron Collider and listen to the information that they talk about on 60 Minutes. It's really, really cool. So, anyway, the one in Switzerland, the Large Hadron Collider, like I said, 17-mile tunnel straddling the French and Swiss border. And they're colliding particles. But many believe that this is setting the stage of opening up different portals to different universes. Different universes, guys. With the way the technology is advancing, with artificial intelligence, machine learning being at the helm of that, and the quantum computers that are all in place now. Most of your large corporations have them, like Google and maybe Facebook, I'm not sure. I know that Lockheed has it, the NSA has it, all of these big conglomerates have this quantum computer. Then you look at the Large Hadron Collider. We are on the cusp of some really eye-opening things that are going to begin to manifest, I believe. Like I said in the first hour, I'm talking about that article in the New York Times about this Pentagon project on UFOs. I think we're going to have a full-blown disclosure about some stuff that we haven't seen before, ever. That's just my gut instinct. I could be wrong. That's my own personal opinion. But I really believe it's going to be put out in a way that's going to be totally undeniable, where any naysayer or whatever would have to just put up. You know, the science is real. The people are talking about it, and they're researching it, and it's there. It's there. I was trying to find some of my articles that I had when I did the series on CERN, but I seem to have misplaced it, because I have all of these other articles in front of me on AI and all of the things that I've been covering for the past year. What an interesting year for Flow of Wisdom. We are winding down 2017. And I will make it my business to continue to breaking down this information and sharing it. I'm very excited for the next subject matter that we're going to cover. I've been preparing for it over the past couple of months and still continuing to do so. And we're going to start kind of trickling into it as we wind it down. Very interesting year. We've covered a lot. And it seems like this whole year was, you know, for the most part, artificial intelligence. And now it's pretty clear it's here. Because all last year, I was talking about, it's coming. And then now, all this year, it's here. But what's going to be interesting is to see how all of this pans out and how all of these different pieces connect together and how it's going to manifest here with all the different dynamics that all of these things kind of connect together with. So, you know, look at what we're dealing with here. We're looking at technology that exists right here, right now on Earth that has the capability of opening up black holes, small black holes. And of course, the propaganda is all out there in television shows and in films, all kinds of movies that talk about. I think Doctor Strange deals with some of the aspects of what we're talking about, multi-dimensions and parallel universes. Is that a Marvel movie or I can't remember which one. It was a DC Comics, but Doctor Strange, if you watch that movie, I'm talking about time travel, traveling to different universes. You think these producers and film directors just pull this stuff out of the air? No. Look, there's articles. It's a fact that the military, the intelligence agencies, the government help Hollywood on films. It's a fact. You can look it up. But they work hand in hand. And the propaganda is at an all-time high, especially with social media. We don't need to get into that right now. You already know how I feel about the social media, right? So anyway, there's lots of articles that are out there talking about these multi-universes. For those that are not familiar with CERN, the Large Hadron Collider, look at the logo. When you type it in the internet, the logo looks like it's three sixes, all kind of intertwined. Then the image of the Shiva goddess, but they have this statue in front of the CERN Large Hadron Collider in Switzerland of the Shiva goddess, the goddess. Right there in front. So there's questions like, why would they, you know, the logo and why is it that they're doing all of the, you know, this using this imagery? Those are questions I've always asked. Always. But, you know, what do I know? You know, some people have speculated saying that CERN is opening up portals to hell. I don't know about all that. But the technology does, in fact, exist to where they're doing something over there. And now China, with theirs built, they're doing something over there, too. They definitely are. So this is very, very powerful. This is very powerful stuff. And, you know, these physicists, they're working on it constantly. So what does this mean for us? What does this mean for you and I? Well, one thing's for sure is that some would say it's the Mandela effect. I don't know. I can't answer that question right now. But I'm searching. I'm seeking. I'm looking to find the answers on how does this apply to us? What does it mean? You know, it's really crazy when you think about the capacity that this this machine's, what they can do. We don't know what it's going on over there, if they're opening up other dimensions where things are coming in. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back after this. It's Flow of Wisdom Radio. Yes. All right. Welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio. Sean Anthony. Listen, I want to take this moment here to send out some gratitude. I want to send some thank yous out as we're wrapping up this show here today. And I'm not sure what my travel plans are at this moment right now. But we may reconvene after the first of the year. I'm not sure. So don't quote me on that. But anyway, I just want to send some thank yous out. This was a really good year for Flow of Wisdom Radio. A good year in a sense of growth and expansion and just overall coming into its own for this show. You know, I first started doing Flow of Wisdom, I think it was in, I can never remember the year. It was 2009 in Richmond, Virginia, on a hip-hop station. I did the night show, but then on Sundays, I was allotted an hour to start a talk show. At that time, I called it The Power of One Voice, because the station was iPower 92.1. And then after about a year, and that was a hard year too, because I've, you know, you talk about a guy that's done, you know, music format radio for his entire career, going into talk radio, it was challenging for me. I had to really learn, one, and grow as a talk radio personality. You know, with that format, you know, music is your clutch. With talk radio, you got to know what you're talking about. Because if not, you're going to be fumbling, stuttering all on the air. But anyway, fast forward, the show gets picked up from a radio station in North Carolina. So my show was heard in Richmond, Virginia, and then North Carolina. And then that's when I changed it to Flow of Wisdom Radio and then pursued syndication. Finally partnered up with the Genesis Communications Network with over a year of communication. Finally, the show debuted on Genesis Communications Network, Genesis Communication Networks, in March of 2013. So fast forward, here we are 2017, and the show has grown and evolved. I want to say thank you to, you know, of course, my family, my wife, and she supported me in this vision over the years. Been very, very supportive, and she still continues to be supportive. I want to send a thank you to my brother, Terry Jackson, also known as Rezo, whom I lost late last year. That brother, man, he was not only a supporter of Flow of Wisdom, but he also was one of my producers. He helped me, you know, edit the shows and stuff. But he was the first person that actually got it. He's seen my vision when many others, when nobody really could see it. He got it early on with Flow of Wisdom. He knew what kind of direction I wanted to go. And it's very rare that you can find someone that can see your vision, a vision that God gave you. You know what I'm saying? This brother's seen it. So when I lost him last year, it really hurt my heart. It really did. But I want to thank him because he helped. He played an instrumental role in Flow of Wisdom when I parted ways with Radio One, which is now called Urban One, and in transition, getting prepared for the syndication with Genesis Communication Network. So special thanks to him. I want to thank my brother Christopher Strickland, who's very supportive of me as well. I want to thank brother Robert X, who plays an instrumental role in guidance and mentorship on his research and stuff. I want to thank the people that have supported me behind the scenes as well. Elise, down in North Carolina. She's always been supportive, her and Rob. I want to thank the callers, the loyal callers and the loyal listeners. I want to thank Leroy in Atlanta, Derek in Chicago, Marcus in Toronto, my peoples in Chicago, other peoples in Chicago, peoples have called in from Florida. I just want to thank you all for supporting Flow of Wisdom. I look forward to continue to live life, get wisdom, and passing it on and flowing it to you all. Peace.